The six northern counties of Ireland are still under British rule. The situation of the Catholics there is parallel to that of blacks in the United States. In America, those in power know that racial discrimination is to their benefit. As long as blacks and whites are fighting each other for the same low-paying jobs, they are assured of a cheap labor market and a supply of scab labor among the unemployed. In Ireland, the same discrimination is encouraged, but along religious lines. Catholics in the north suffer from unemployment and discrimination in housing. In the predominantly Catholic town of Derry, 20% of the population is unemployed, and Catholic families are kept waiting for up to 17 years for public housing. In 1968, a campaign of nonviolent demonstrations was launched by various adult and student groups. The RUC, Royal Ulster Constabulary, and the Paisleyites, a right-wing Protestant group, met these peaceful demonstrations with water cannons, firebombs, and clubs. The RUC ran through the Catholic Bogside district of Derry, smashing shop windows and beating passers-by. They were thrown out of the ghetto by force, and the Bogside was barricaded.
The police, the RUC, erected barricades across the streets that lead into the Catholic ghetto of the Bogside. The RUC, in fact, created a rigid religious demarcation line in this city. Could not lock up a people in a ghetto and expect the people not to be resentful of it.
This is 4-3 Derry broadcasting on 200 meters medium wave. Special news flash has just arrived in. Hold on, folks, don't switch off yet. This is Radio 3 Derry broadcasting on 300 meters medium wave band.
We have been asked tonight to announce that because of the difficulties being experienced by the people of the city at this time, a special mass will be offered at St. Eugene's Cathedral at 7 p.m.
Three pregnant women came out of their houses and said, look, we can't fight. What can we do? And this fellow said to them, great, down my back garden, I'll get you all the stuff you need. And he sat there on upturned boxes, the three of them, as merry as could be, discussing whether they were having boys or girls or what they were buying and making petrol balls. It was great, they sat there pleasantly. They just made away. And the unending hail of petrol bombs that came ever after were not from a month's store, but from the hard work of women and kids.
No, I can't see how you say you can say that the Catholics hate the Protestants. This is not so at all. I myself, even through all this trouble, I have worked with Protestants. I still work with them. And they're good people. They live under the same conditions as a lot of Catholics in the Bogside. They suffer the same injustices as you all know. I won't go into the political or economic side reasons behind it, but you know, it plays into their borough. They keep the common people at one also, because while the common people fight one another, they can't fight the people who control the system.
The very question of the legitimacy of armed struggle never even enters our thinking. Everyone knows, everyone accepts the legitimacy of armed struggle. I suppose in some countries who haven't got this tradition of armed struggle and of continual fight for their rights, fight for liberation, this probably does become an issue. But as far as we are concerned, there's no question whatever about the right of any nation to use any means whatever in order to achieve its independence, its liberation from any imperialist power. People don't like the word revolution, but there has to be a revolutionary change in society.
I know there's a lot of white kids going to school without breakfast because they don't have the money to buy it.
The Black Panther Party, with the Free Breakfast for Children program and free medical clinics, has shown us how we can begin to meet our own needs. Other groups, both black and white, tenants' associations, welfare rights, community-controlled child care groups, and radical caucuses within unions, are beginning to show us how we, the people, can work together to achieve our basic human rights.
There was a family movement, a black family movement in a neighborhood in Dorchester, and the kids like of that neighborhood started stoning the house and rushing the door. And so he called the local police, and he waited something like 2 hours, and nobody showed up. And then he called the Tampa headquarters, and they were down 15 minutes patrolling the house.
Right.
But it really turned the kids on, you know.
But turn the white kids on?
Yes.
The white kids really respected that.
Yeah.
That they were going to defend themselves.
Yeah,
and they got
defend, right.
Well, police is a filthy word. We have a peacekeeping people. They are there to keep the peace. They patrolled the area last night. They don't come along as policemen in this country come along and say, clear off or you'll get clobbered. They come along to somebody who looks as if he's going to do something which is of no use to anybody and explain to him why he shouldn't do it.
Well, my name's John Hargan.
Mm. How old are you, John?
15. Well, we're not against the Protestants. We're against a B-man. We are fighting for the freedom and the rights to march on the streets. As Emma McCann says, fight and you'll get your rights. We'll be ready to fight anytime.
Now, we must probably have the most politically conscious children in the world. Events in Derry have developed the political consciousness of the kids in this area. The next generation of kids will beat hell out of whoever enforces an unjust society amongst people. We are beaten now. We will not be beaten for long.
But nobody seems to be afraid of fascism and police states or anything else, and we're supporting dictatorships all over the world.
People won't admit there's white ghettos too. They don't want to admit it.